seem to have been pretty close so far. They're both new, so it's hard to weigh in a lot about like past experience.
Well, Halmac just rolled a 74 and Avery only rolled a 17. So,
oh, I mean, well, there we go.
If their luck has anything to play into it, clearly a perfect predictor of who is the better player.
No, where are you, Crockett?
Gavi, yeah, no, both of these players are brand new to the SSO. It honestly, mad props to them for offering to do something like this. You know, it can be very nerve-wracking, your first tournament in, just because you're not used to all those eyes on you.
Yeah, and it being the loser semifinal, we're going to see some of the maps in the 30s, which are a little bit easier. So that sometimes can bring out a different skill. Like if somebody is comfortable with 30s gods, but less comfortable with 40s, you might have someone who can PFC something in the 30s, but can, even if they can still like get through a 40s map like pretty well. Sometimes going down to 30s can mean that a PFC is more likely to happen. So that can make it so that like minor differences in accuracy or even big differences in accuracy don't matter as much. If someone can PFC with poor overall MS, then that... Yes, Hal is new to the SSSO, not the community. That's correct, Quasi. Hal has been pretty active in the server.
Hal is a pig box enjoyer, so that's a plus from me.
Oh, they're going to be playing Running to the Sea, which is a banger. We got Crippy cheering in chat.
Who's how? I only know David Gaming.
David Gaming, let's go.
David Gaming. Aren't we all David Gaming on the inside? Neither of these players with an FC on this map. How having a slightly better score. They're literally a place away from each other. Hal's number 9 on the leaderboard. Avery's number 10 on the leaderboard. So, can't ask for much closer.
And this is also, I believe, it's possible that there might have been a call-up in the previous SSSO, but I think this is the first SSSO where we've had Steven chart. I could be corrected, though.
I don't remember.
Avery already with a drop on the FC. Halmac dropping the PFC.
Halmac dropped a pretty big slider at the beginning. So... That's going to be in the back of his mind, the whole song.
Pick is asking, can music be raised a bit? Nice. I really love this song and this chart.
Avery with another miss. Definitely those nerves after just coming off of fighting Trekster, you know.
There are also quite a few dense match strings and wacky sliders in this one. So it's pretty easy, like even generally playing well, to just drop little things here and there. Mm.
Seems like even after the misses, yeah, with that slider break in the beginning, they're barely close in
Yeah, I can't actually score. Tell.
Avery with another miss that may put Halmec slightly ahead now. Yeah.
Yeah, I think a miss tends to be about 200 points.
But yeah, with that slider break that Konomi brought up in the beginning, that Halmec had, those misses that Avery had just ended up closing the gap between the two. And now with these, it's pushing Halmec further ahead.
Mm-hmm. It is still pretty close overall, though.
Mm-hmm.
And this was like a, 4 minutes off?
Quite a long song. It's not Anime Bouchal, but it's a decently long song.
Do we know what's the longest and the shortest chart in the pool this time?
Yeah, somebody more knowledgeable than me may be able to say that. Maybe pick the playtester, I think.
I think it's PP Breaker. That song's like 7 minutes.
Oof.
PP Breaker 7 minutes?
Yeah.
That's the one that person's 8-year-old passed, right?
Yes.
That blows my mind. I have an 8-year-old.
Somebody's 8-year-old.
Not mine. Not my 8-year-old.
Who's the sassy lost child?
This sassy lost child passing 70s that are 7 minutes long. We did have another miss from Avery toward the end. But the last like 30 seconds of the song are all like long spins and sliders.
So base score, Halmec ahead right now. Avery would need a crazy good MS compared to Halmec to take this. They're slightly under 2,000 points away from each other.
Trex is saying it's about 4 minutes, the PB breaker. Okay. I was just going based on what someone else said. I don't play 70s.
Okay.
Less than 4 minutes long.
Is it really not 7 minutes? Oh my god.
Maybe it feels like 7 minutes.
I guess so.
All right, we're getting misinformation from both players here. All right, we're getting the longest one is Rude Buster.
Yeah, you're right.
Million PP is over 7 minutes. That may have been the the mix up there.
Yeah, I got my PPs million mixed up. My bad.
That just goes to show. They can't tell the difference between a longer PP and a shorter PP, so.
God, let's keep it PP.
So, Mappy says longest one is Rude Buster, the shorter one is one of the butterfly ones.
One of the, three, four butterfly mixes in the tournament?
Butterfly upswing mix is a minute 30.
Hmm.
Honestly, Butterfly, one of the banger songs of the 2000s.
3, 2, 1, go.
They're going to be playing Slip, which is a pretty interesting song and chart. Haxton is new to submitting charts to the SSSO, and worked really hard to get a couple of charts in. Has some really interesting charting style. We got a miss from Howe early on.
Yeah, this kind of intro doesn't fare too well on higher scroll speeds because there's a lot of weird movements coming at you that you can't read too well.
Axton's name just reminds me of TF2.
I think it's supposed to be like the play on words.
TF2 has Saxton Hale.
I think his Steam ID is like, yeah, Hexton's
there. We've got a miss from both players now. Avery.
Yeah. Prog says when you can submit three charts, a super long one usually won't be a priority. Yeah, however, comma, we need another 7-minute infected mushrooms chart.
Akko is saying that the audio is a little quiet, but I think it may be that the chart audio, the audio for the chart was a little bit quiet. It's not the audio source thing.
Judge will have me covered in the future. Yes.
These same lane tap swaps throw me off every time. and then the opposite lane tap swaps that follow it. it's definitely a pattern that can catch people off guard if they haven't played the chart ahead of time. Or if they just haven't played it recently.
Another miss came out of Hal. Was putting, I think Avery slightly... Is it slightly ahead, or how close are they?
This might have been a pretty strategic pick from Avery. I don't know how much each player has practiced the map pool, but if they, like, it's possible if you know which songs, like, tend to be the weak point of another player, then you can sometimes turn something in your favor.
Definitely a benefit of the customs leaderboards. Back when that mod was publicly available, I know that a lot of Jammy used to make a whole spreadsheet on who was better at what charts.
We got like a 350 point lead from Avery lead going into this. And they take it.
Avery takes it.
Avery gets their first SSO win. Let's fucking
Yay,
go.
Yay, Avery. Good job.
Huh?
Huh?
It's a 1-1. It's 1-1.
Yeah? No, I know. They won a song.
Yeah, but they both won a song.
The song. They have each won one. No, this is just their first song that they've won. You know, it's nice to, like, regardless of who's playing, to, like, not go through the tournament without taking any map, you know, like...
Let me know when you're ready.
That'll be press start. Ooh. Again, these players are one off in the rank in the leaderboard. Wait, no. No, they're not. Where's Halmax situated? Halmax situated on 19, not 15.
Oh, wait.
Oh.
Yeah.
Is the diff supposed to be 39? Because in mine it's 37.
Oh, 39, that's for the sheet. It's supposed to be 37 in game.
Oh, alright.
So for those who may have seen the spreadsheet for charts in this SSO, the way that things work is that charts will have their difficulty in game, but that may be different than the difficulty that they were rated on the SSO spreadsheet. Because the SSO spreadsheet is graded independently of suggested difficulty off of the charter.
Yeah, I believe Prague has a tool that aggregates the difficulty sorting that the playtesters put the charts into and gives a difficulty for... It ends up giving the full list of difficulties based on that data.
Yeah. It's not a definitive source of difficulty, but it's pretty good, I think.
Yeah, it's a tool that's used towards that.
Yeah, no, but so are you guys talking about Prague's difficulty?
Not the auto-rater. I mean that playtesters put the songs into a list of what's easiest to hardest by what they consider, and then that it aggregates that information and rates the charts as a result. I'm not talking about the chart analyzer tool. Yeah, we didn't use the automatic rater, but we do use the previous order one. Compiles the playtester ranks. Yes. Gabby asked to practice and use the tool for this one, though it's still just experimental. I'm not talking about the new one that rates the difficulty of any given chart by reading the chart data. I'm talking about the one that takes the playtester ratings and aggregates them.
Yeah, so Prague's other tool that's used, it makes it so that the playtesters don't have to come up with concrete numbers for each and every chart. Considering how many charts there can be, it can be really, really difficult to come up with proper numbering for all of them, you know, in what, a month, 2 months' time. Yeah, Gavi, this one, it's only used for SSO. So it looks like HowMac is in the lead by about 800 or 900 points, roughly. That might be really? More like 6. Might be more like,
yeah, it's a few hundred. I don't think it's quite like 900. Oh, with those few more misses, it's possible, yeah.
Yeah. Especially those compound misses, you know?
Yeah, having your multiplier drop even lower than 3x can be pretty devastating to your score.
Now a difference of about 1,000. Both of them getting a new best though, so you can't. 7,300 on the dot.
Ooh, nice.
Nice job, HowMac.
Very carefully planned, I'm sure. Every good was calculated.
Yep. Every good and every MS was perfectly calculated. To get 7,300 exactly and win the set with it.
GG's, HowMac, you are moving on to the Losers Finals match. Facing off against the winner of this upcoming match, the Winners Finals.